know and how to do different things in relation. And it's very helpful for parents, especially helpful for conducting different trainings. And there is not so much data, unfortunately, available in Ukraine in our local language or even in Russia. So we still, we do sometimes lack of really good content and very good training programs on that.
Okay, that's really good. I can try to send you guys some information on stuff like that if you'd like.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let's go. That would be great. Если ты хотела бы поделиться этой информацией, что
будет? У меня просто моя презентация на русском. Я же ее в результате переводила, поэтому я могу, например, там есть ссылки на сайты, с которых я брала информацию, но я ее именно компилировала из разных.
Yeah, the thing is that Evgenia would also be able to share it with you, but unfortunately, it's only in Russian, you know, so you just didn't get the whole idea of the work, but it's actually the accumulative knowledge of all that was available more or less in different countries, mostly in Western and English.
Я ее могу в том виде, в котором у меня есть, переслать. Но она именно презентация собрана. Ну, сейчас я посмотрю тоже.
So,
я сейчас найду, где моя, тоже пошлю.
Basically, while the colleagues are searching for different work, I wanted to ask you one question. It's personally my question. How do you balance, you know, your condition and actually your life? Because for me, it was a huge challenge. It took me like almost 20 years I lived with this. And with epilepsy, and it was like half of this road was like I didn't fully even recognize the disease itself. I was just saying, no, it's not mine, it's not for me at all. And it was hard to me even become like honest with myself about
it. Yeah, it was hard. I remember I hid it for a year and a half. I know anyone who had it when I was first diagnosed. I did tell people, some of my friends stopped talking to me, stopped inviting me out. They went wonky around eventually, but as to like activities and everything, going for like swimming and bike riding, stuff like going for walks, I had to have a friend or family member with me. Because I had a seizure coming home, walking home alone one time, got lost.
How do you balance with everyday life in school and stuff?
The school, my teachers are very understanding for the most part. I usually try to go, like, I'm in college, so one day I'll have a class like 2:30, one all the time I'll have a class till 10:30. So I schedule things for after class time or before. Work around that way. Make sure I get a lot of rest too. It's a lot of scheduling, a lot of keeping track of what's going on,
yeah.
Not sweating the small stuff.
What actually makes the big difference is that I was actually was almost in the middle of my university studies when I was diagnosed, and so I have to manage schedule sometimes on my own. You know, so it's more like an adult life, so to speak. So it was a little bit heavy, and like it took me a lot of time. Being an adult person already, it took me almost 10 years to rebuild my schedule, to rebuild my organization, to rebuild my day and everything. Yeah,
it definitely takes some time getting used to life knowing you have epilepsy, life with epilepsy in general.
Adjusting,
not letting it stop you. Also, I would say with the information work that you're trying to find, I can get that, I'm trying to get that translated so I'll be able to read it. And if it's okay with her, I'd like to share that as well.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
Awesome. okay, that's.
Вот да, то мы как заскучали.
Ну, я I wanted to translate our conversation, so you just give me a pause. я просто спросил, как удается балансировать между заболеванием и жизнью, как это, насколько это тяжело. И она сказала, что, ну, у меня типа было преимущество, наверное, в том, что я могла уже раньше, будучи ребенком, приучаться к очень четкому графику того, что я делаю, как я делаю, планированию и так далее. Это все достаточно очень жестко. Если человек, наверное, вначале этого не придерживается, да, то он имеет, конечно же, и большие проблемы. Я поделился своим опытом, что у меня, допустим, как у человека, которого мы диагностировали эпилепсию, уже будучи в университетском возрасте, да, мне было немножко сложнее. Мне, наверное, пришлось потратить минимум 10 лет на то, чтобы как-то изменить свои привычки, перестроиться, да, под какую-то модель. И то, наверное, на 100% еще к этому не пришло. А вот Кейси в хороших руках, наверное, и работают достаточно ответственно и серьезно. Вот как-то так. Павел is asking you, what city are you in? And how is Corona getting? How is coronavirus? Is it there?
In a general sense, so I live in Canada, Nova Scotia, and how many cases do we have here now?
Over 100.
We have over 100 cases now. We've been self-isolating since the idea of self-isolating was first brought up. Because I have a compromised immune system. And I also just don't want to get it and then risk spreading it to someone else. So
most of our businesses are shut down.
Most of our businesses are shut down. Most restaurants are only doing drive-through, if that.
Business is essential personnel.
Yeah, basically it's just essential personnel working that has to get done without causing damages.
Mm-hmm. So you're actually living in Halifax, right?
Yes.
Yeah. Павел, Кейси живет в Калифаксе, это Новая Шотландия. И у них зарегистрировано сейчас больше 100 случаев уже. И публичные места полностью закрыты. Людям предлагают в основном заниматься уже находиться в self-isolation. It's by the way the same as we have in Ukraine with restaurants, public transport, everything is banned completely. No international flights, no even transportation across inside the country, between the cities. But nevertheless, we have spring and it's warm and sometimes people still go to picnics.
Yeah.
It's
so good
here.
Not crazy. It's crazy. We go outside for walks and stuff, but like in the woods or something like that, not where the other people that would
get it. Социального дистанцирования какого-то идут гулять куда-то в лес, еще куда-то, но не находятся.
Ну да, как и у нас.
By the way, как это повлияло на твои на Purple Day в мире? How did it affect the Purple Day globally, this coronavirus?
A lot of the events got shut down or postponed. So we did a lot of video conferences similar to this on Zoom or on Instagram and Facebook. A lot of messaging people. And then I got people to try to turn their social medias and social media groups they're a part of turn purple. Spreading awareness that way. And it was actually really, we were really busy. We were home, thankfully.
Can I translate this? Yeah. Несмотря на то, что, короче, много ивентов, ну, много событий, все-таки мероприятий, которые во всем мире запланировались, были отменены. У нас вот таких звонков у меня каждый день, я вообще как бы немножечко даже устал от них. Ну, то есть их достаточно много, вот, и тем не менее активность происходит, очень много в онлайне, с разными организациями мы контактируем и продолжаем работу, очень много в Инстаграме даже есть интересных событий, которые происходят, и активно двигается это все. Окей? Okay?